Welcome back. Now, it's the moment we've all been waiting for. It's time for us to reveal our mystery guest.
So, sit back, relax, and enjoy our special Valentine's Day gift for you.
I've got sunshine on a cloudy day. When it's cold outside, I've got the month of May. Well, I guess you say, what can make me feel this way? It's my girl. Talking about
my girl, I got so much honey, the bees envy me.
I've got a sweeter song than the birds in the tree. Talking about
my girl,
ooh. I just want to say a very special Valentine's Day to everyone at home, especially my beautiful girlfriend, the GC, Gemma Collins. This one's for you, darling. Talking about
my girl, ooh. I've got sunshine on a cloudy day with my girl, even got the month of May with my girl, oh.
Talking about my girl.
Smile so much during the song.
During
well done, you.
Oh, I really enjoyed that.
So that's dedicated to the GC.
Absolutely, sir. Valentine's Day, I want to dedicate that to my girlfriend and also everyone out there at home. Even if you're not got a partner or whatever, that song's out there
well,
for you.
Well, you are absolutely off the hook now because you've done that for Valentine's Day. What have you got plans for later?
Well, she's going to be coming into London later and we've got a beautiful room booked up at the Dorchester.
Oh,
it's her favourite hotel.
Nice?
Only the best for the GC. No, no, it's not a surprise.
Oh,
okay, she demanded it.
I was going to say.
Do you ever call her Gemma?
Yeah, of course I do. Yeah.
Did she pick a present for herself or did you pick one?
She picked a few presents for herself. Yeah, she's got a bag on the way. She's got a beautiful bunch of red roses, a nice hotel room. Yeah, you've got a.
Which she picked.
She picked. Yeah.
did she know about this?
She did know about this, yeah. She's watching at home, you know, chilling out by the sofa and she's cheering us on.
Are you glad to have her back home now?
Absolutely. Don't get me wrong, it was nice, you know, having a bit of peace and quiet when she was away at rehearsals, but but at the same time, I'm proud of her, what she done on Dance and Ice. I thought she absolutely smashed it, and it was her time to leave, and now we can spend quality time together.
Oh, she did very, very well,
she
didn't
did. I'm
she?
Very proud
you were
of
worried
her.
About her going in, weren't you?
I was worried about her. I just, all I wanted to, you know, see her do was try her best and give it a roll, and I really felt she did that. And she was amazing entertainment, week in, week out. There was always something to talk about. And I thought she was fantastic. What a great booking.
Were there any... What a great booking. Precisely. Were there any moments where, when you were watching it, you know, went, oh, God.
Oh, man. There was many moments, yeah. There was, you know, when she had the back and forth with Jason, like, I was rooting for her at the start, but then I was like, right, enough,
oh,
Gemma,
no,
like,
zip
it. But it's fine, it all worked out for the best. And obviously, when she had the fall, that was really tough because it really affected her confidence and stuff. But the fact that she went straight back on the ice and she continued, I'm really proud
of
her.
Well, her mum is a massive fan of Jason.
That's what's
really?
No. And her mum agreed with everything that Jason said.
The funniest thing about it is Jason can do no wrong in Gemma's mum's eyes. So it's hilarious because Joan, she seems to agree with absolutely word for word what Jason says every time. So,
so she can't bring her mum for support.
No, you can imagine how that went
for
down.
So have we signed you up?
Do you know what? When Gemma left on Sunday, I was walking round and I was and I'd all like the is it Brandy and a few of the other girls, Alex and stuff, and they were like, "Oh, we're going to be your partner next year. We're going to be your partner." But I tell you what, in this time next year, hopefully I'll be a year and a half sober. Yeah. I'm going to get 7 stone off. I'm going to get fit and healthy. And if I do Dance on Ice, I'm not just going to be a competitor, I'm going to be a contender to win it.
Oh, okay.
Trust me. Wow. And we can show this back when we do next year.
Well, he will do that. He will absolutely do that.
No question. That'll be great.
That'll be amazing. One last question for you. You spoke last year and you said that maybe this year is the year that you might get down on one knee.
You never know.
It's Valentine's Day. You've got the suite at the Dorchester, like you've said.
It is Valentine's Day, obviously. Darts and Ice has taken up all of our time and efforts.
Your fault.
But if it's done now.
But you know, that's done, it's out of the way. So, yeah, you never know. Hopefully, there'll be some things for me and Gemma to look forward to this year. Let's see how it goes.
Gemma,
nicely dodged. Nicely dodged. What a mate. Thank you very
much.
Look, there you go. It's the Arg Band.
Come on.
There we go.
Thanks, guys.
How did you come up with the name? I don't know.
Genius.
Thank you very much. Right, still to come, Vanessa Phelps answers your love life dilemmas right after the break.